Hi students, in this session I am going to teach crystal field theory. This crystal field theory was developed in order to explain some of the properties like color and magnetic behavior of the coordination complexes, and also it is used to explain the nature of the bonding. Now let us see the salient features of CFT. CFT, which is nothing but the crystal field theory. With the first point, the bond between the metal atom and the ligand is assumed to be ionic in nature. Okay, this bond is formed due to the electrostatic force of attraction between the electron rich ligand and the electron deficient metal. Okay, the second point, if the metal atom or the ligand is charged, means charged in the sense it may have the positive sign as well as negative sign. Okay, if it is charged, they are considered to be point charges. Okay, if it is neutral, we know that we have three types of ligands: negative ligand, positive ligand, and the neutral ligand. Okay, if it is neutral, they are considered to be electric dipole. This is a second point. Okay, if it is charged, it is called point charges. If it is neutral, it is considered to be electric dipole. Then the third point, how the complex is formed. Okay, in order to form a complex, always the ligand will approach the central metal atom. Here also, in this case also, the ligand will approach the central metal atom. The metal atom will have the d orbital, that we know that. Okay, d orbital will have 5 orbitals. Okay, 5 orbitals, in the sense we can say this as a degenerate set. Okay, degenerate in the sense it will have the equal amount of energy or same energy. Okay, these 5 orbitals is to be named like dxy, dyz, dzx, and dx square minus y square and dz square. Okay, there is one difference between these 3 and these 2. Out of these 5, the first 3, can you see that one clearly? Yes. Okay, the first 3, dxy, dyz, dzx. Okay, in this case, the lobes are present in between the axis. Okay, the lobes are present in between the axis. But in the last 2 cases, the lobes are present along the axis. See here. Let us take octahedral field. Octahedral field in the sense 6 ligands will approach the central metal atom. Okay, when a ligand approaches the central metal atom, that time there develops a spherical field of negative atmosphere. Okay, that time there develops a spherical field of negative atmosphere. Due to that, the central metal atom will experience the repulsive forces. Due to that repulsive force, the degeneracy of a d orbital will be lost. We know already what is mean by degeneracy. Degeneracy, which is nothing but it will have the equal amount of energy or the same energy. Okay, when it is lost, the energy will be higher. Okay, it will not have the same energy or the equal amount of energy. Okay, so they develops a non-degenerate orbital or average energy of the d orbital in a spherical crystal field. Okay, non-degeneracy means it will not have the same energy or it will not have the equal amount of energy. Again, it can be this non-degenerate orbital will be split into 2 types. One is EG and another one is T2G. Before that, I want to explain what is EG and what is T2G. Okay, see here. Already we have seen this one. Okay, if the lobes are present in between the axis, okay, if the lobes are present in between the axis are called T2G set. Okay, if the lobes are present along the axis are called EG set. Okay, lobes are present in between the axis are called T2G set, and the lobes are present along the axis are called EG set. This is according to the spectroscopy. So this non-degenerate orbital can be split into 2 types. Okay, here also why we have written EG up and T2G down, there is one reason. Okay, see here, listen carefully. This T2G orbital, T2G set, which is nothing but the lobes are present in between the axes. Okay, Y means when a ligand approaches the central metal atom. Okay, when a ligand approaches the central metal atom, the lobes present in between the axes will experience the lower repulsive forces. We can say like that. Okay, it will experience the lower repulsive forces. Instead, the lobes are present along the axis will experience the higher repulsive forces. So T2G set will be decreased. The energy of the T2G set will be decreased because the lobes are present in between the axis. The energy of EG set will be raised because the lobes are present along the axis. Okay, see here again the splitting, the energy difference between EG orbital or T2G orbital is called crystal field stabilization energy. The energy difference between EG set and T2G set is called crystal field stabilization energy or crystal field splitting energy. This can be represented by delta. Okay, am I clear to you?